it tough doing a panel with a brand new show where you can't really reveal a lot, but you're still trying to bring the hype for the show?
It is absolutely tough doing that. And it's also tough because most people haven't seen it. We don't know what to expect. And considering we've just started, we don't even know what we're doing. We don't even know where we're going. So we only can share so much. And thankfully, everyone's going to show the pilot later today. And I can't wait for people to see what we've done. And I hope people enjoy it.
What can you tell us about your character?
I play Max Evans. I am a cop, a deputy of Chavez County, where Roswell is. I've lived there my whole life, and I protect my brother and my sister, and we try and protect ourselves from the world, because we are aliens, and we don't know how we got here, or where we came from, or the extent of our abilities, but we have to kind of keep that between us.
So how does it feel to play someone who's an alien? I mean, what do you do extra that kind of gives it that new dimension?
Well, you know what's funny about it? I think everyone, as people, we've all felt alien at some point in our lives. We've all felt like we don't necessarily belong somewhere. Mm-hmm. So that's just amped up to a slightly higher level. It's, you know, I don't know how you're doing today. I don't know how you're feeling today. I'm not in your skin. And that's something that I think is just a very human experience. So it's almost just deepening that sort of understanding. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, we don't know any different. You know, me and Michael and Isabel, we don't know what another way of living would be. You know, we've only known this one way. It's sort of fun to play with.
Did you draw any inspiration from the original series?
I had never watched it initially, and when I got cast in this, I asked Corinne McKenzie, our creator, if I should watch it. And she said no, because here's the deal. We're taking these characters from the books, and we're jumping ahead 10 years in their lives. They're not in high school anymore, you know. We are adults. We've had life experiences. We've had heartbreaks. It's not this sort of young love full of hope thing. And it's still there. There are still roots of it. And we see those start to come out as Liz comes back and myself and Liz get to know each other again. But there's 10 years of life that we get to fill in. So we're starting fresh, which is really fun.
Is there anything in particular you really love about him?
About myself? About Max?
Yeah, about your character.
His loyalty. His loyalty to his family and to the people that he cares about. That's been very important in my life, and to be able to share that with Lily Coles and Michael Williams, who play Isabel and Michael. It's been really fun to build that relationship, and I just love playing with those two, and the banter and the history, it all sort of comes together.
How do you make the adjustment from doing something like True Blood, where kind of no holds bar, and you get the R rating and everything, now you're going towards, you know, the CW.
Yeah.
What's the change in that like?
It can be frustrating at times, because like you said, when you're doing a show like that on HBO, you don't feel restrained in any way. Obviously, different situation here, but I've worked on shows like this as well, and you just amend your language is the main thing. Watch your mouth. Pretend you're around, you know, your friend's parents, and you'll be fine. So that's really the only adjustment.
Save the cursing for the blooper reel.
Exactly. Yeah.
And now they were mentioning Chris talked about a murder mystery. How are you involved with this?
I can't give too much of that away.
Yeah.
I'm involved because it's Liz's sister who we're trying to figure out what happened to her. So that being said, I care very much for Liz and everything that she's going through. I take on a little bit of, just because I've been alone through my entire life. So I sort of go with her on her journey to try and figure out the truth.
So do you believe in aliens?
I do. I absolutely do. I have for a long time. I think I love the Science Channel. I watch it all the time. I love how the universe works and all this. And it's just unbelievable to me, with the vastness of space and the vastness of the universe, that we are the only tiny little speck that has life. No way. That's absurd.
So can you touch on how the show is actually portraying aliens? Like, I know you guys are seen as humans, but
yeah, well, we're talking about alienation and aliens in several different contexts. So we have the literal aliens, who are sort of the obvious hammer to the face of alienation. But then we also have immigration issues that we're talking about. We're talking about illegal aliens, people coming across the border, and even within the community, how different immigrant populations alienate each other. And so there's a whole lot of different ways that we're talking about aliens. Now, the literal sci-fi ones, we haven't really explored yet, and we'll get to that. But the idea of an alien, we play with in a lot of different levels. So hopefully we can keep doing that.
So is there a particular moment that you can't wait for the fans to see play out on the screen? Without major spoilers, but you know, just
I mean, I would say one just broad moment that I think a lot of people will be looking forward to is when Liz and Max are finally on the same page, which will take a little while. I won't tell anyone when, I won't tell anyone why or how, but I think that's a moment it'll include a lot of fans of the original. It'll be what the newer fans are fighting with us towards. So really excited to move towards that as we get towards the end of the season.
How much information do they give you about his backstory and about his growing up?
Quite a bit. And we use flashbacks a lot to sort of explore why things are happening the way they're happening and how relationships started and how people fell apart. So I get a lot of feedback, and the creators of the show have been really great about sitting with us and talking things out. If we have questions, they're really good about talking to us. Now, there's some things that even they don't know yet. You know, we aren't sure exactly how the show ends this season. They aren't either, you know. They have an idea, but, you know, they don't want to tell us something that turns out to be completely wrong, because then we build that into what we're doing, and then we're like, take backs. So they're very good about communicating with us, which is really, really helpful. I've worked on shows where they weren't, and that's very frustrating. So it's been a good experience.
How does it feel to be a part of this, like, the CW kind of universe, this, you know, Riverdale and Hunter and all these shows coming out? Like, they're really, you know, just kicking butt right now.
Yeah, the CW's doing a lot of great stuff. And, you know, we sort of, they have the Riverdales, and I think we're sort of on the older end in terms of a demographic, which is something that it's really important to us, because we're not high school kids anymore, and you know, we don't necessarily want to tell high school stories. So we sort of get to be more the top end, and CW's wonderful about trying to bring in as much conversation as it can about various topics, and we're just glad to be a part of it.
How
does
it feel filming a season like
honestly, it wasn't difficult to play Max at all. Max, when we first were casting, I was reading for Michael, actually. And it was, they couldn't find a Max, and then finally someone was just like, well, have Nathan do it. And so I had to shift my entire worldview and just really settle into Max's perspective. And suddenly it felt so much more comfortable. And it really just blossomed. And it was very strange how that worked. But Max has been, I've loved playing this character. And I'm so excited going forward to see what else we can do. It's been a blast. I love it.
That's a huge shift, though, when you think you're doing something else and going into
It was. I had to reread the script. I had to erase everything and read it fresh, with fresh eyes. Which was, I had never had to do before. So it was super fun. It's super fun to explore. And, you know, I find Max mirrors my life a little bit better than Michael, even. And, it's just crazy how these things happen. Yeah,
happens for a reason.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
The aliens.
Exactly. Their plan is working.
Are you going to be able to enjoy the convention after the panel? Are you going to be able to, you know?
Not as much as I'd like to. We fly out first thing tomorrow because we're back at work Monday. So hopefully I'll get a chance to at least hear about it a little bit while I'm here. My brother lives in New York, and he's going to be wandering around. So hopefully when I meet up with him later, he can recap it for me.